We are going to see a most important example in group structure, that is symmetric group. Now here are the learning objectives. As we have seen before, we have to understand the algebraic structure group, and then we go for a study of a properties of a group. So here is the outline. What we are going to do today is we have a quick revision on a permutation on a set, then we go for a symmetric group definition and its example. Now firstly we take a look on permutation. What is a permutation on a set? On a given set, permutation is a map that is 1-1 and onto. 1-1 and onto means there is a different image for a different element, and there are a same number of elements in both the set. As we define permutation on a same set, so there will be a same number of elements. Now what is 1-1 and onto? We roughly say that it is a proper pairing between two sets. Now set of all permutation on a given set A, all possible permutation, that is all possible 1-1 and onto maps on A, are denoted by a set Sn. That is, set Sn contains set of all permutation, that is all possible 1-1 and onto function on a given set. Now the permutation is represented as or write as in a matrix 1 f of 1. F of 1 is an image that defined by a map 2 f of 2 and f of 1 and so on. Let's take here one small example of permutation. Suppose we have a set containing a two elements 1, 2. Set have only two elements 1 and 2. And we have to define a permutation on a set X. Now we are going to define a map from set 1, 2 to 1, 2, which is 1, 1 and on 2. Then we can define a permutation F. As what we are going to do, we are going to define a map, and map gives a image to each element and a unique image. So we can define one image to one, we can define image to element two. This is a one permutation on a given set containing two elements. We can define another permutation as G is equal to, we have to define a images of a elements in the set, that is we have here 1, 2. So we can define image 2 to 1 and 1 to 2. Here is the second permutation. This is a simple example on a permutation. So we see another example on permutation. So here is the example on permutation. Here we have a set containing 5 elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then permutation F is given as 1, 3, 2, 5, that is we define a unique image to all these 5 elements under F and under G. F and G are elements of S5 because set containing 5 elements. So this is the examples of permutation. How we can define permutation on set and how to write it. So nextly we have to consider a composition, or firstly we go for a cyclic notation. Here is the cyclic notation for a permutation. We say a cycle is complete when we start from one point and end on a same point. So keeping that in reference, we see a cyclic notation or permutation or cyclic permutation. So we have defined here a permutation F on a set containing 5 elements, that is F is a map that give unique image to each element. So to make it a cyclic, what we are going to do is we start from 1. 1 have image 3, so 1 have image 3. Then we look for a 3, 3 have image 1, again 3 have image 1. We are at starting point, so here we complete the cycle. Then we start another cycle with 2. Now 2 have image 5, so I take here image 5. 5 have image 4, so I take here image 4. And 4 have image 2, so we end at starting point, so here I complete the cycle. Now this is a cyclic notation for a permutation F. Okay, and this permutation is called a cyclic permutation. Okay, so let's try a G. We start with 1, 1 goes to 4, 4 goes to 3 here, again 3 goes to 5 here, and finally 5 goes to 1, so here we complete the cycle, and 2 goes to 2, therefore 2 has only one element in its cycle, so this is the cyclic notation for a G. So this is the cyclic notation for F and G. That reduce the area, and it is very easy to do calculations on a permutation. So now we go for a composition or product of a permutation. Now how to take an operation on permutation. So here is the composition. Composition of a two permutation. We have two permutation, beta and alpha as given here, defined on a set containing four elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now as we see, permutation are the functions. Now when we operate two function f and g, what we do on some element say x, we do firstly we calculate a image under G. We do f of g of x. The same thing we are going to do here. To find a composition of two permutation, what we are going to do, we take a first element 1. Here is taking 1. So what is image of 1? Image of 1 under alpha is 2. So here g of 1 is equal to 2, and finally we are going to see the image of 2 under beta, 2 going to 1, so finally 1 going to 1. Take another example 2, here 2 goes to 3 and here 3 goes to 4, so finally 2 goes to 4. 3 goes to 1. 1 goes to 2, so 3 goes to 2 finally. 4 goes to 4 here, and here 4 goes to 3, so 4 goes to 3 here. This is the composition of array notation. So it is very important to understand the composition of permutation, because when we are going to see a group structure, we are going to do this composition. So finally we are going towards our main topic, that is symmetric group SN. What is symmetric group, and we have to check whether it is forms a group under composition or not. So here we have defined a symmetric group SN. What is mean by SN? Set of all permutation on a set containing n elements. So here we collect all the possible permutation, that is all possible 1-1 onto mapping that can be defined on a set containing n elements. In particular, we are going to consider a symmetric group S3, that is set of all permutation on a set containing three elements. Before going toward the S3, just practice here S2. Now S2 represents set of all permutations defined on a set containing two elements 1, 2. Let's have elements 1 and 2. So what are all possible 1, 1 and on 2 function that can be defined on this set X? We have set 1, 2. So firstly we can define image 1 to 1, 2 to 2. This is trivial mapping or identity mapping. Nextly we can define image 2 to element 1 and image 1 to element 2. This is another possibility. So and there is no other possibility because we have only two elements, that element of 1 may vary 1 or 2. So here are only two possibilities. So set S2, that is set of all permutation on set containing two elements, contain only two elements that are represented here. So in similar way we have to calculate all possible elements for S3. Now here we have three elements 1, 2, 3. So here are 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and we have to define different 1, 1 and on 2 mapping on the set 1, 2, 3. Now firstly we define 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, that is trivial or identity mapping. Then we define 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1. Then we go for 1 goes to 3, 2 goes to 1, 3 goes to 2. Then we go 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1 and 3 goes to 3. Now here we fix 3, similarly we can fix here 2 and here we fix only 1. So then we write element as 1 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1 and here we 2 goes to 3 and 3 goes to 2. These are all possibilities for 1, 1 and on 2 mapping that can be defined on a set containing 3 elements. Now for calculation we must have their cyclic notation. So here is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. It is an identity permutation we denoted by I. So cyclic notation, we start with 1. Here 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 3. And again 3 goes to 1, therefore here is the complete cycle. What happened here? We start from 1, 1 goes to 3, here 3 goes to 2 and 2 goes to 1, here we complete the cycle. Similarly here we start from 1, 1 goes to 2, 2 goes to 1, so we complete the cycle, and 3 goes to 3. We sometimes write 3, or we can for simplicity we can keep in this mind that 3 goes to 3. So here the cyclic notation is 1 goes to 3, 3 goes to 1 and 2 goes to 2. So there is 1, 3 is the cyclic notation, and finally we are 1 going to 1, so we start from 2 goes to 3 and 3 goes to 2. Now these are the elements of S3, all the elements of S3. Now we have to check whether these elements with respect to operation composition forms a group or not. Now we know the properties of group, that is closure property, associative property, identity, inverse. So do this, we must have to take a composition of every element with each other. So this we will done with the help of composition table, Cayley table. So we have to do some composition. I just doing one or two example, the rest of we can do. So what we are going to do, identity into identity, how it is going to done? No, identity is identity into identity, we have to do the calculation. Identity into identity, 1 2 3 1 2 3. So when we do identity into identity, what we are going to do is we are going to find another composition, that is we are going to find the images of 1 2 3. So what we see here, 1 goes to 1 and here also 1 goes to 1, so finally 1 goes to 1. Similarly 2 goes to 2, 2 goes to 2, 3 goes to 3, 3 goes to 3. So identity into identity is identity element. Okay. Similarly you can do identity into 1, 2, 3. Now we are going to do identity into 1, 2, 3. Let's do here one example, identity into 1, 2, 3. So here is the identity and here is 1, 2, 3. So we have to find a composition. So we have to check the images. Here 1 goes to 2 and here 2 goes to 2. So here 1 goes to finally. Now, then 2 goes to 3, 2 goes to 3, here 3 goes to 3, so here finally 2 goes to 3. Here 3 goes to 1, 1 goes to 1, so finally 3 goes to 1. So, identity into this permutation is again the same permutation. So, here we get identity. And here we get 1, 2, 3. So we have to do all the composition and we have to find a complete table like this. This is a Cayley table for symmetric group S3. Now by using this table, with the help of this table, we are now going to verify that is S3 forms a group under composition or not. To verify this, we have to check these four properties. First property is closure property. What is meant by closure? That is when we take composition with each other, the result will be in a same set S3. Now from a Cayley table, we observe that all the composition have result in a same set S3. All these answers are these elements from S3. So from table it is clear that S3 is closed with respect to composition of mapping. Now associative property, you can check yourself. Associative means when we take three composition F, G, H, you have to take three compositions and firstly we have to do calculation in this order. We have to find firstly GH and then operate on F, and nextly we have to find firstly F composition G and then operate on H. You can do this associative property. Now we have to check if there is identity element or not. Now from table, when we operate I on any other identity permutation, on any other permutation we get the same permutation again. Here I into I, I into 1 2 3, I into 1 3 2, I into 1 2 and so on. So here identity permutation is an identity element. So here is exist identity element in S3 with respect to composition. Now last one is existence of inverse element. Is there is a inverse for each element? Let's see. When we operate identity on identity, element is identity, so inverse of identity is identity. Now for 1, 2, 3, when we operate 1, 2, 3 on 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3 on 1, 3, 2, we get a result as a identity element. So 1, 2, 3 is inverse of 1, 3, 2. Now when we operate 1, 3, 2 on 1, 2, 3, result is identity. So 1, 2, 3 is inverse of 1, 3, 2. 1, 2 also have inverse. 1, 2 have inverse itself 1, 2. 2, 3 have inverse as a 2, 3. And 1, 3 have inverse 1, 3. So from table it is clear that all the elements have inverse. So we can conclude that finally the set S3 forms a group with respect to operation composition. Okay, now finally we go for a 5, we say this is as a symmetric group. Now symmetry is a motion in a plane that keeps the structure or shape unchanged. That is, all the elements of S3 are same as different symmetries of a equilateral triangle. The symmetries are obtained by rotation, by 90 degree, by 180 degree, by reflection about various angles. So therefore we called it as a symmetric group. These are the same elements. Here we just use ABC, and in first example we just give notation 1 2 3. So this is the example of symmetric group S3. You can find S4, S2 for practice. Thank you.